वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ संजय पाटिल
एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी नेक्स्ट पार्ट, पार्ट टू फॉर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मशीन. सो इन आवर लास्ट प्रेजेंटेशन वी हैव स्टडीड मशीन्स एंड मैकेनिज्म, डिफरेंस बिटवीन मशीन एंड मैकेनिज्म, देन फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी, देन इंजीनियरिंग मटेरियल्स, देन इंट्रोडक्शन टू फास्टनर एंड फाइनली इंट्रोडक्शन टू मशीन एबिलिटी. सो नाउ इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी इंट्रोडक्शन टू लेथ मशीन, then introduction to drilling machine and introduction to milling machine. So now let's start with lathe machine. Okay. So the main function of lathe is to remove metal from a piece of work to give it a required shape and size. This is accomplished by holding the work securely and rigidly on the machine and then turning it against a cutting tool which will remove metal from the work in the form of chips. So a workpiece is mounted in the chuck, and the chuck is given rotational speed, and the cutting tool is held on the tool post. It is clamped in the tool post and it is relatively moved between the workpiece. So we will be having relative motion between the workpiece and the cutting tool, and this is how the material will be removed from the work in the form of chips. Now, types of lathes, then first is speed lathe. Speed lathe is the simplest form of lathe, and it has high rotational speed, that's why it is called as speed lathe. Second is engine lathe. The difference between speed lathe and engine lathe is that in case of engine lathe, we can have a variety of speed steps. So we can achieve variety of speed steps achieved in case of engine lathe. In case of next type is bench lathe. So basically bench lathes are small lathes which are used to machine smaller components. Generally the swing area of the bench lathe is around 250 mm. Okay, so that much small component can be used to machine on bench lathe. The next type is production lathe. So it will consist of automation lathe or capstan and turret lathe. So basically production lathes are used to machine bulk quantity or mass quantity of the components. Then next type is tool room lathe. So these are the precise lathe which are used to carry out different operations in the tool room. Then next type is special purpose lathe, lathes are designed for carry out only the specific operations that are indented. Then next type is NC and CNC lathe. So these are the various 7 types of lathes. Now let's see the various components of lathe. So you can see this is the bed of the lathe, and on this bed various components are mounted. So you can see the headstock, and this chuck is attached to headstock. So headstock will consist of motor and different gears. So speed from motor to this gears can be transmitted. So you can see tailstock. This tailstock can be moved forward or backward depending upon the dimension of workpiece. So it will be offering support to the work which is mounted on the chuck. Then you can see the saddle or the tool post. Okay. So that can be moved on the guideways of the guide wheel is mounted on the bed. So on the saddle you can see this is the tool post. Then compound slide and cross slide, that two slides can be used to move tool or to adjust the tool. So this particular saddle or tool post can be moved by using this hand wheel. And finally you can see the lead screw. So on this particular lead screw, the saddle will move forward and backward. Okay, so this is the various components of lathe. So now operations carried out on lathe is turning, which includes OD turning, ID turning, then drilling, then threading, then we can have parting, then we can have chamfering. Okay, so these types of operation can be performed on lathe. Next, introduction to drilling machine. In drilling machine, holes can be drilled quickly and at low cost. The hole is generated by the rotating edges of cutting tool known as drill, which exerts large force on the work clamped on the table. So now type of drilling machines are portable drilling machine, which is a small drilling machine and used to carry out or used to drill small components. Then radial drilling machine, where we will be having a swing of arm of that particular drilling machine. Okay, so gang drilling machine, where number of drilling operations can be done in case of gang drilling machine. In case of multiple drilling machines, multiple spindle drilling machine, we will be having multiple spindle. So at a time, number of drilling operation can be done in case of multiple spindle drilling machine. And finally, automatic drilling machine. So you can see the drilling machine figure. So this is the base, and on this base all the assembly is mounted. This is the table, then this is the vertical drill spindle in which the drill is mounted. Then this is the sleeve. Now you can see this is the cone. Now this is the motor, which is mounted on the head, and from this motor or from this pulley to another pulley, you can see the V belt. This is how the power is transmitted from this motor to this particular drilling vertical drill spindle. And you can see this is the vertical solid or rigid column. Okay, so this column is mounted on the base, and this column supports the spindle and the motor, driving motor. So this is the construction of drilling machine. Next, introduction to milling machine. Now one point we have missed. In case of drilling machine, we can have operations like obviously drilling, then reaming. Reaming is a finishing operation which is carried out after drilling. And after reaming, we can have tapping. So on drilling machine, we can have operations like drilling, reaming and tapping. Okay. So next is introduction to milling machine. So milling may be defined as a machining operation for removing excess material from a workpiece with a multi-tooth rotating cutter. Flat or curved surface of many shapes can be machined by milling with good finish and accuracy. A milling machine may also be used for drilling, then slotting, then making circular profiles, gear cutting or helical milling with suitable attachment. So these type of operations can be performed on drilling machine. So types of milling machine. So basically milling machines can be bifurcated into vertical milling and horizontal milling. So obviously construction for both milling machines is different. So you can see the vertical milling machine. So why it is called as vertical milling machine? Because this spindle on which milling cutter is mounted, this spindle is vertical. That's why it is called as vertical milling machine. So you can see this base. On this base, a rigid column is there. So on this rigid column, there is a swinging head. You can see. So then this is a spindle in which milling cutter is mount. Then this is the knee, where this knee can be moved up and down on this screw jack, and these are the guideways. Okay, then you can see the saddle. Then table is mounted on the saddle, and the saddle can be moved in this way. Okay, so the tables will be having T slot, and on this T slot the work will be clamped, right? So the workpiece will have motion like upward and downward, right? So in this way the workpiece can be moved, and this is the swiveling head where this particular cutter can be swiveled, so that there will be easiness of milling machine or milling operation. The next is horizontal milling machine. So why it is horizontal? Because this spindle is horizontal, or the R bar is horizontal. So you can see here a cutter is mounted on this R bar. Then you can see the base, then column, rigid column which is mounted on the base, then overarm where spindle and arbor is mounted. Okay, this is the cutter. Then this is the elevating screw. So the knee can be moved upward and downward on this elevating screw. Then this is the saddle. On this saddle, table is there, and table will be having T slot on which the workpiece will mounted. So this is the horizontal milling machine. Okay, so friends, that's all from my side. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.